Hello everyone, I'm Yolanda and I'm currently taking the class Interactive Programming in Python on Coursera given by Rice University. I'm going to be talking a little bit about the remainder operation or modulus and how you can use that to implement this week's mini project, Rock, Paper, Scissors, Lizard, Spock. First, I'm going to talk a little bit about the modulus function. It's represented by the percent symbol and returns the remainder when two numbers A and B are divided. The result will always be between 0 and b, where it can equal 0, but it cannot equal b. So let's look at an example. Calculate 7 modulo 3. One way to think of it is like long division. And when you finish this problem, you find that the remainder is 1, and so the answer is 1. Another way to think of it is to imagine a clock and count up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And after 12 is not 13, it's actually 1, because we're going back around. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so on, and the cycle repeats. Why am I telling you this? This is an example of something modulo 12, because the clock goes up to 12. To solve our problem, we need to construct the clock that goes up to 3, like this. Now we just count to 7, and where we end up is our answer. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So our answer is 1. And really, 3 here should be 0, because the answer has to be less than 3 and greater than or equal to 0, like this. Yet another way to think of this problem is by using a table. We're looking for 7 modulo 3, so we need to construct a 3-column table starting with 0. Our answer is a number less than 3 and greater than or equal to 0, so our answer will be in this row. Then, we locate 7 and go up the table until we find the answer, which, in our problem, is 1. You can also calculate a modulus that involves negative numbers, and you can use any of the techniques from before to do so. Here's an example. Find negative 8 modulo 5. In the long division method, I find that the remainder is 2, and so the answer is 2. Note that I set 2 as a number over here because I want my remainder to be less than 5 and greater than or equal to 0. We can also use the clock method to solve the problem. For negative numbers, we count counterclockwise, so negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, negative 5, negative 6, negative 7, negative 8. And so again, our answer is 2. Our last method is with the table, and this time we have 5 columns. This time we need to fill in the numbers before 0, 2, because we need to find negative 8. Our answer will be greater than or equal to 0 and less than 5 in this row, so we see again that negative 8 modulo 5 is 2. Here's another example, 8 modulo negative 5. To solve this, we're just going to use a table method, since this is a method I think most people prefer, but you can use the other ones if you like them better. So we have a negative number here, so we're looking for a number less than or equal to 0 and greater than negative 5, this row over here. We locate 8, and we move up until we find our answer, negative 2. Our last example is negative 8 modulo negative 5. We use our same 5-column chart, and we're looking for a number less than or equal to 0 and greater than negative 5. We locate negative 8 and see that our answer is negative 3.